slot to the far side. Lone receiver to the near side. Radford calling for the football out of the shotgun. Gives it to Matthews up to the 10, the 5. Touchdown, Ryan Matthews.
Welcome back to Eagles Game Plan, and joining us as he will every week here on the show is Eagles head coach Chip Kelly. Coach, how you doing?
Doing good, Ike.
Doing good. Let's take a look at some of your plays here from the preseason. Let's start off with the offense. Offensive line, great blocking, starting with number 71 there.
Yeah, JP came back to camp in great shape. You know, obviously we're running a play here in the red zone versus the Ravens. Just our typical zone play where we're moving these two guys out in this manner. We got a combination block going here. Because we've got four over here, these two guys are actually working to that linebacker. Those two guys are working to that linebacker. So JP is responsible for the middle linebacker, but we've got a big edge rusher on this side. So he'll help Brent Celek, and they'll kind of combo block here and then come off and press C.J. Mosley, who's a great player in his own right. And now Ryan Matthews, who's a new addition to our team, does a great job of pressing the line of scrimmage, bringing this ball all the way here, getting the linebacker to commit, and then reading JP's blocks coming off here. It's just a well-blocked play everywhere around. We do a great job, and there's a huge hole for us. It sprung us for our first touchdown in the Ravens game.
Yeah, great job there. You know, guys blocking together. Look at here on the defense. You talk about playing run defense, being gap sound. Mm-hmm. Every defense has an area where they want the ball to sort of end up at. Mm-hmm. And great job here by the guys up front forcing this ball outside.
It is. You know, obviously they're trying to build an extra wing here by bringing the receiver in motion. Malcolm does a great job of getting his responsibility. He's responsible for the D gap. Connor does a great job in the C gap. We're two gap in here. He'll show hat and make the running back bounce. And really where it's trying to go is to our unblocked guy. So as this receiver came up and commits and what we call crack block on Malcolm, then the corner should arrive from the outside. And then young linebacker for us, Jordan Hicks, should be playing this inside out. And we've got him protected on this play. And it's exactly how you draw it up defensively. We've occupied all their blockers. Here comes Byron Maxwell from the outside. He's got outside contain. And Jordan Hicks has inside contain, and it's really a tackle for no gain.
All 11 guys contribute mm-hmm. in stopping the run where it only shows up to maybe one guy on the stat sheet.
Exactly.
That was run defense. Looking at the pass defense, thing I like about this play, Coach, they give a great play action sort of action, and you're prepared to stop the run with penetration here and mm-hmm. the pass on the back end.
Yeah, you see both of our linebackers scrape if it were handed off and working in this direction. So they're scraping for the run. Once they realize it's a pass, then everybody will now latch on or plaster to their guys in terms of great coverage. As you see the quarterback roll out, we've got a hat on a hat. We've got great coverage everywhere. Malcolm has eaten this up. We're playing a pass-off zone bracket coverage where we'll pass that off to the safety, and now he'll zone high for him. But we've got every guy covered, so we put the quarterback in a situation where there's nowhere to really throw the ball. And then it turns into a run for him. We get a short four-yard gain. But you look at our pursuit, and it all started because of the coverage and our ability to plaster and stay with everybody and don't give the quarterback an option. A young quarterback at Green Bay that did a real good job, had a good game against us, but on this play, he didn't really have anybody to throw the ball to.
Yeah, and penetration up front from those guys definitely killed their play. Your big guy to emphasize is all three phases of the game. Mm-hmm. Special teams, big part of this team's success last year. Off to a great start in the preseason here. Big punt return.
And part of it is that we've done such a good job in our hold-up return. So if you run this play and let the ball, once it's kicked, and you look right now, both gunners aren't even 5 yards downfield right now. We've got a great double team going on here. We had a great double team where he was starting out of bounds, couldn't get out of bounds, comes back in, and now we have another player waiting for him. So what we always talk about is to give the punt returner a chance to get it started and stop it right when he catches the ball. He's just about to catch the ball, and look how far away everybody is. So he has at least a 10-yard running start before anybody can even get to him. And then we do a great job of walling it on the outside. Our other opposite gunner, now if he's done securing his guy, we tell him to go next level. So he'll pick up a block here. And then you see our guy start to turn. All he does is E.J. Biggers just gets a piece of him. We do a great job. That's Jeff Mayle right there doing a great job on the return. And now Kenyon, when you get him out in the open field, understands and has great open field vision. And as he comes back and cuts it back, we pick up a block right here. Here comes Jalen Watkins right here. And then Eric Rowe, who started this play way outside as a gunner, as a jammer on our gunners and stopped the gunner from getting down the field, ends up being his lead blocker as we take him into the end zone. And Kenyon had two of these on the year. We did an outstanding job in our special teams. Don't like him not securing the football as he goes across the goal line. But he spent a lot of time with Darren Sproles. Darren had really talked to him about getting the ball up the field, making sure you catch it going vertically. And then we pick up some real good blocks here. Jordan Hicks does a great job with the holdup at the line of scrimmage. We do a great job with a holdup at the line of scrimmage here. But the biggest thing is when the returner has a chance to catch a football, look how much the area he has to run in. And, you know, and that's the key is we can get something started in a positive direction. It's not always going to go a return all the way. But when you pick up blocks like that from Jeff, then here comes Jalen, and then here's Ero coming in on the backside. Great vision by the returner. We do a heck of a job. And that was his second one on the year. Had one against the Colts also.